More than just a contest for the presidential nomination, there is a fight for the conscience of the Republican Party, and, for a change, Nevada is right in the thick of the battle. His critics may be right that U.S. Republican Ron Paul is unelectable, although prediction already has proven to be a dangerous occupation this election year, but his supporters already have shown that they understand the dynamics of party politics a lot better than most of the rank and file of the party. Even such battle-scarred veterans of the party as former Nevada Governor Robert List, who lost his position as national committeeman at the party's state convention this past weekend, learned that lesson. After losing the Nevada Republican caucuses to the presumptive nominee Mitt Romney earlier this year, Paul won a decisive majority of the party's delegation to the Republican National Convention, 22 of 25 delegates on Sunday, making national news a day later. The National Party has threatened to discipline the Nevada Party for its lack of discipline. But if party members aren't happy about the outcome, it's fair to ask what they were doing while the Paul forces were organizing to take over the state convention. The lesson for the rank and file is, if you want to affect the decisions made by your political party, you have to participate. Paul's supporters did. Everyone else didn't. The old stereotype of the American political parties is that Republicans are well-disciplined and Democrats are unruly. At the height of the unrest over the Vietnam War, for instance, the 1968 Democratic National Convention in Chicago turned into chaos. Rioters were pummeled on the streets, and TV reporters were marched out of the convention center. The delegates nominated the Happy Warrior, Vice President Hubert Humphrey, over U.S. Sens. Eugene McCarthy and George McGovern, and leading to reforms in the process. Meanwhile, the Republican National Convention in Miami Beach was a celebratory affair, nominating former Vice President Richard Nixon, who'd wrapped up the nomination early in the process. This year is turning the stereotype on its head, however. Nothing has come easy for Romney, and a Nevada delegation bound by the rules to vote for Romney but, in their hearts, preferring Paul will only add to the feeling of unease that must still haunt the Romney campaign, even after all of his other challengers dropped out. Nixon must be rolling over in his grave. But if there's anything that can be said without fear of contradiction about democracy, it's that it's messy. It's that mess, however, that both cleanses and clarifies. By the time the national convention is over, Republicans will have a much better idea who they are and what they stand for. Paul and his supporters will see to that. And, if those who stayed home when the delegates were being elected don't like what they see, well, they'll only have themselves to blame.